We have an email query now from K.R. Natarajan. He plans to invest in an under-construction project in Mumbai. Now, the developer is asking him to pay a service tax of 4.5% on the apartment costing 85 lakh rupees. Natarajan wants to know whether or not it is valid. We've already answered it, but let's have a go again.
Yes, well, we've answered it, and 4.5% is the uniform rate at present. So you will have to pay that on the 85 lakhs, which is the consideration.
You know, when I also think that a lot of these questions are also coming because of the Delhi High Court order on service tax. In fact, we've had callers on the show who've asked us outright, why should I pay the service tax? Since the Delhi High Court has ordered saying that, you know, there is a problem with the computation of service tax. So should I just say I will not pay it? What should buyers do currently?
Well, since this is a Delhi High Court order, first thing you must remember it that people who are residing in the territory covered by the Delhi High Court can probably take that stance that I will not pay. Hmm. People who are not in that geographical region will not be able to take this stance because you're not covered by this particular judgment. So I'm sure nobody wants to litigate against the department. I mean, for example, sitting in Mumbai, you can't litigate against the department. You know, it's a very tough call to take. Secondly, even this decision of the Delhi High Court may be challenged by the department. There may be an amendment in the law, maybe in the forthcoming budget. So with all this uncertainty, if you do want to contest, then you'll have to really take a call whether should you pay it and then contest, or are you willing to take that chance to contest now and then maybe later on find that you're being asked to pay interest, you're being asked to pay penalty. So fighting with the department is not an easy task. You will have to take proper legal advice, understand the implications of what this fight will lead to, and then take a decision in the matter.
Right, and for all those viewers who've not really followed what the order was, essentially the Delhi High Court ruled in the favor of a buyer here. The buyer had actually brought a case in court against the developer, not against the tax department, asking why he should be paying service tax. The High Court went... In its order, the High Court essentially said that there is a problem with the way service tax is computed. The math is wrong because there is a lot that is not really covered by service tax when you buy a house. So, for instance, preferential location charges, etc., do not really come under the purview of service tax. The service that the developer is rendering over here is merely constructing the house and giving it to you. Land costs, for instance, should not be computed when you are calculating service tax, which is why the Delhi High Court ordered that residential property, sale and transfer residential property should not be covered by service tax. However, this is something like Vinay just pointed out, this is a Delhi High Court order, not necessarily valid across the country. The other thing is, there is a chance that this order will be challenged in court, which is why you will be taking a chance if you choose to take a stand and not pay service tax. The better thing to do would be to pay the service tax and move on.
You can watch live TV on our website, mpnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at magicbricksnow. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.